Hey guys, today we are going to look at k-means clustering, and we'll use Iris dataset. Clustering is an unsupervised learning algorithm, so it's trained on features only. In other words, we don't need to give the algorithm labels. The goal of clustering is to summarize and find patterns based on the features of the input data. Without further ado, let's look at our example. First, we need to import the packages we need to use. Then we can import our data. I've downloaded the data and saved it in the same directory here. I'll put the link of data in the description below so you can download the data set we use. All right, so data equals to pd.read.csv and the name of the file. Then we can look at our data for a second. So we have four features: sepal length and width, petal length and width. Then we got this label attribute here, the variety of flowers. I know I said that clustering doesn't need target attribute, and that's true, so we won't feed this attribute to the algorithm. Therefore, we need to separate the features and the target attribute. X equals to data I log. Y is target attribute. So this minus one here means we only want to keep the last attribute. And this means we want every attribute except the final one. So let's check our feature. So yeah, our feature only contains four attributes now. And we can also have a look at our labels, although we are not using it in our algorithm. Now we know we have three categories in the label attribute: setosa, versicolor, and virginica. Next, we need to standardize the feature. K-means clustering is a distance-based method, so we want every attribute to have the similar mean and standard deviation. Otherwise, some attributes will weigh more than the others. Fortunately, it's simple to do standardization in Python. We just need a standard scalar. It'll standardize our data to the mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1. So we first create an instance of standard scalar and fit transform our data. However, this will return a NumPy array. But what we want is the data frame. So we have to manually convert the data back to data frame for later steps. So x equals to pd data frame x columns. This is just when we want to specify the column names in this new data frame. And this is basically just the column names here. And we can see, yep, we successfully transformed our data. But to check if the data is indeed standardized as we want, we can quickly check the mean and standard deviation of each attribute. So I'll copy and paste some code here to save the typing time, because it's just basically calculate the mean and standard deviation of each attribute. So yeah, the mean is super close to 0, and the standard deviation is either super close to 0 or exactly 1. Sorry, I mean standard deviation should be 1. So we successfully standardize our data. The next thing we do is reduce the dimension to two features. In particular, I'll use principal component analysis. It's fine if you don't understand PCA. It uses linear combination to create principal components based on the original features. I'm doing this because I want to plot the data in a two-dimensional surface, which is just a fancy way to say computer screens. So I can only have two features. We specify components to two, and we again use fit transform and convert it to data frame. Yeah, the color name changed because we only have two attributes now. And I will call it PC1 and PC2, which stands for principal component 1 and principal components 2. we now have only two attributes, which are our principal components. Then we can see what our data looks like. Again, this is just plotting a scatter plot. The code is really simple. This one is just for decoration for the label and title here. So it seems like two clusters might be a good choice. Since the data can be roughly divided into two big categories, the left one here and the right one here. But we can use a more scientific way to find out the optimal number of clusters, and that is elbow method. So in short, elbow method will show the sum of square distance of each data point from its own center, the center of its cluster, and we want to minimize the distance, but we don't want the k to be too large, otherwise we might overfit the data. So we use a line plot to show the relationship between the sum of square distance and the k. So I first create an empty list, sum of square. Then we can iterate over the candidate k. K means equals 2. And we build a model instance here. Number of cluster equals to k. And we fit our data. Then we can use this attribute here. This will automatically generate the sum of square distance of samples to their closest cluster center. Append, I forgot to edit. Okay, then we can plot our line plot. I will again copy and paste the code I have here. So from the line plot here, we can see the line becomes much smoother after this point. So 3 might be a better option than 2, since it has much lower sum of square distance. And although we already knew there are 3 types of flower in the real data, most of the times we don't know the true labels, so we have to use elbow method to help us select the optimal k. Anyway, we can now decide the optimal k to be 3. We can move on to building and training our model. This step is actually surprisingly simple. We just create a model instance and put the features in. K means equals 2. K means cluster 3, because we just decided as the optimal number of clusters. And K means model equals 2. K means the fit X. Here we are. We have our clustering model. But this is not the end. We have to evaluate our clustering. In this example, we knew the label, which is the species of flowers. So we can plot the clustering results on one graph and the actual grouping on another graph. So here is the code. Basically, the first one here is the predicted cluster. And here is the actual cluster. So this indexing is just the condition when the prediction cluster equals to index 0, 1, or 2, we plot it in a separate color. And for the actual data, we also use the condition to index. And here we are. We can see the left one here is the predicted clusters, and the right one here is the actual grouping. One thing to note is that the color here doesn't matter. The clustering is just grouping, but it doesn't have any practical meanings. So we just need to focus on if the flowers in the same group are actually the same species. For the setosa here, the data is grouped into one group, the yellow one here. However, for the versicolor and virginica, some flowers are in the wrong group. It's because there are some overlapping regions in the original data here. K means clustering groups data with similar characteristics or the cluster data points. So it just groups the upper ones together and the bottom ones together. Having said that, the clustering did a fairly good job. As you can see, most of the flowers in a group belong to the same species. Nevertheless, most of the time we don't have the labels. In that case, we can do two things to evaluate the cluster. First, we can calculate the intra-cluster distance and inter-cluster distance. Intra-cluster distance is the distance among data points within a cluster, so we'd like it to be as small as possible. Inter-cluster distance is the distance between two different clusters, so we want to maximize the distance. By doing so, we can make sure the data within a cluster are similar enough, and the data in different clusters are different enough. Second, if we don't want to do so, we can also compare the features of the clusters. For example, we might want to group the customers based on their behavior. So we want their behavior to be as different as possible so we can decide our marketing strategy based on their characteristics. Okay, I'm getting off the topic. Back to this example, we can compare the mean and standard deviation of the principal components. To do so, we can store the key value pairs in a dictionary, and then we can convert it to a data frame. So first, k equals to 3 because we have 3 clusters. Then we can create a list. The data frame of clusters is x. K-means model labels equals to I for I in range K. Let me just check this. I just have a typo, I guess. So this will return a list of length 3. It's because we have 3 clusters, so it just stores the corresponding rows in a list. And then we store the list together into a bigger list, so it's a nested list. Anyway, we can now calculate the statistics. And basically, we just use this comprehension for each value pair. And I think you can understand how I generate this, right? So let's look at the result directly. As you can see, cluster 0 has very low average of PC1, while cluster 1 has low average of PC2, and cluster 2 has high average of both PC1 and PC2. And that's basically what defines the clusters. In the real world, you can make strategy decisions based on the characteristics like this. All right, that's pretty much it for K-means clustering. I'll put the code in the description below. Thank you for watching my video and hope you enjoy it.